Hey everyone, did you know you can create t-shirt designs in Placeit? Yes, the place that you do mockups on that I usually use to create mockups, really good mockups. You can actually create designs in there and they have a whole list of templates. Now you don't have to stick to the templates. The reason I'm doing this video is someone asked me, can you add backgrounds to it and upload different things like from Creative Fabrica and stuff? And you actually can. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how to upload those things into a design in Placeit and create designs that are different than the templates that are already there. So you can mix and match and use their fonts. They got actually a lot of fonts. So let's go into Placeit right now and I'll show you a short tutorial on how to create designs using Placeit. All right, so here I am on Placeit, placeit.net. And this is the place that I use to create mockups. Like I use it a lot. You can see you have the mockups by type, Gildan, Bella Canvas, mockups for Etsy. I'm not gonna go over how you do that, but it's super simple. If you ever want me to do a video for it, you basically just drag in your image here, make sure it's the right size, and it does it all for you. But in this video, I'm gonna show you something that most people don't use Placeit for, at least I think most people don't use it for, I don't, is design. So you come in here, design, merch and print, and you can go to t-shirt designs. Now they have, look at all the other designs they have. They have a bunch of other stuff, whoops. But we're gonna do t-shirt designs today. If you wanna see another video about other designs, I can do that as well. But basically it works the same. We're gonna go t-shirt designs, and you probably didn't know they have a ton of them. Look at this, over 400 pages of it. And you can see here where they have over almost 4,000 animal t-shirts, 30 art print, 21 avatar, and so on. The list goes on and on. Food t-shirts, 1,600. Like they have a ton of different ones. And you can come in here too and browse all the designs. And let's say you wanna just do, I don't know, hobbies. There's a bunch of hobbies too. Maybe you want gaming. Boom, there you go. How many pages of gaming? Over 12 pages of gaming design. So I'm gonna show you an idea that I had to go look up is when someone asked, can I put a background in it? Because some of these I think could use a background. Like I think that could use a better background. That could, like some of these are just hanging out there. So I'm gonna show you an idea that I came up with. Well, testing so if I can use my background. So I'm gonna come in here, I'll pick this one. Actually, I want some other ones. So the nice thing is you can start looking at like, maybe I want this one, maybe I want, oh, this one's nice. So you can kinda go on here and if you want gaming, it kinda suggests to you can different things. So if you want the look of this one over this one, you can do that. The next thing you would do is just hit edit. So I'm come in here and now I can come in here and just change the font or the whatever it says. So I'm gonna change it right here to the top. You can see the font right here and the color. This is where you change what you want it to say. So I can say, I paused my game. Boom, like that. And I can make it bigger or smaller, just like that. And I can change the color. Whoops. Oh, you can use AI to help you write something else too. I didn't know that. I can change the color to white. There we go. And so on. And I can even change the font. So let me do this one. I pause my game to be here. Like that. And let's check out the fonts. I told you they have a ton of fonts, right? Look at that. That's just the suggested fonts. When you hit more fonts, look at that. That's crazy amount of fonts, right? So yeah, they have a ton. They have a ton of fonts. So I can pick out something like maybe like that. And or if I don't like that one, sometimes it's hard to know what it looks like. So you have to go back to suggested. And maybe I want this one instead. There, that's nice. And I can do that. And I can even change the colors of it to the colors in here. So I can come in here and use custom, and then there's this eyedropper tool, and I can pick any of the colors that's right here. So it's right by your the arrow, not the dot. So don't put the dot over, the big dot over it, it's where your arrow is. So you can see there, that's yellow, and that's that, and that's that. So I'm gonna pick the color of this controller, boom, really neat. I can also change the color of the background. So if I want this background to be a different color, let's say a darker color like that, cool. So one thing that this needs, at least I think it needs, is I like to fill the space with like a background here. And this one doesn't have a background, and you can see I don't have anything here. And I could add one. I could come in here, add a graphic, and do like background. But a lot of times it doesn't do it. Like you could do a sunset maybe, and it doesn't like always give you the best ones. So if you have a background, luckily I have a pack of backgrounds in my digital download. So that's this one right here. It's only $4, but there's 10 of them in here, and I'm gonna show you how to upload one. So I saved one to my desktop. I'm gonna go upload an image. I'm gonna pick one of these. I'm gonna go to desktop, and there's a bunch of things I did there. The one I want is this wavy checkerboard PNG. I'm gonna double click that. And there you go. This is one of the things that I have in my background. I'm going to put it there, and I can crop it so that it's with this here, this down here. I can crop it to make sure that it's big enough right there, so there's not a lot of white space. And what does this background do? Oh, let's see. Oh, it removes the background, but my background's already removed, so it's totally fine, I think. Oh, no, it did a bad thing. So don't do it on that one, but it can remove backgrounds if you need it. I think in this case, it didn't need it because I already moved the background. So I'm gonna hit crop here, and you can see it's right there. So one of the bad things I noticed is there's no way to like move this back and forth. At least I couldn't figure out like on here how to move it in layers. Like I tried to move it like this. So my hack for that is to duplicate this one. See this thing right here? If I duplicate it, hit like that, it does another one, but in the front. So that's one way to do it. I'm gonna delete this back one and put this here. And now I have this background, and I can put this, make this bigger, and it kind of fills that space and adds more color and so on. Now you can keep a whole bunch of backgrounds back here. So I'm gonna add another one, add a graphic, uploads. And you can see I've uploaded a couple of them already, a few of them that I did. Now I'm gonna change it to this. Actually, I can edit. I think I can edit the other one. So let me try and edit the background that I have here. Edit. Yeah, so if I edit the background instead of adding a new one, it can do that. So it's already in the back, so I don't need that one right there. All right, cool, isn't that neat? So another thing you can do is get a design from Creative Fabrica. So I went to Creative Fabrica, I found this design right here. I downloaded it, and it's a PNG on my desktop. So it's not gonna match this gamer thing, but I'm gonna show you what it looks like. So I'm gonna add, we have to get rid of these. I think you can only add so many designs. So I'm gonna delete this one, or go to different upload. Oh, here we go. The one that I downloaded is this cute Halloween ghost. So I'm gonna hit that. And let's see. Boom. This is from Creative Fabrica. Isn't that cool? I'm gonna hit crop. It's gonna take a little while, but it should put it right in here. There it is. So if you wanna use something from Creative Fabrica, you actually can. You can download it and put it in here, just like you would in Canva or Affinity Designer, you can actually put it in here. But I'm not gonna use it because my words and stuff aren't gonna match, but I could, you know, if I found a Halloween design that I like in here with the words and the fonts and everything, but I wanna switch out the picture or the graphic, I can do that with Creative Fabrica. So I'm gonna get rid of that one. I think I'm just gonna keep this one. Make sure the background is centered. One thing that's nice is you can see those lines when it's centered like that, boom. And then this one can be there. This is great. And I pause my game to be here. Good. And that's my finished design. Now I can save it, I can download it, and it will download it without the background if I choose so. I can do this. And I believe it will just maybe automatically remove the background. Or maybe I have to do it myself. Let's see what it comes up with. I'm not really sure. If there is Yeah, it looks like it has the background on it. Let's see. I'm gonna pull it up. Yeah, it looks like it's on it there, and that's probably because of if you want a poster with the background, then you should do that. So what I would do instead is I would go to here to background, and I believe you can do no background. There you go. And so this will be the one that you'd want to download. I'm going to download this one now, and let's see the size. I didn't check the size the last time, so let's see if this is big enough. It should be. It looks like it's big enough when I pulled it up. I'm going to download, click here to download, and then I'll show you the size of it. All right, so here's the size dimensions, 4,000 by 4,800. It's not quite 4,500 by 5,400, but it's big enough and you can scale it up. And it came out really clear. So if I went in and zoomed in, like look at those lines. It's pretty clear. So I'm not worried about scaling it up just a few hundred pixels. It's a great size to do it. And another thing is you can automatically put it on some of your mock-ups right here. So if I want this one right here, I'm just gonna pick this guy and I can make the mock-ups with the design I just made. I don't have to like add it to it because it already knew. I can just do this and I can crop it now. Let's resize and let's move it up like this. There's a preview on this side on the right, of course, so you can see what it's like. And you can use this, you know, for marketing or social media or whatever, or maybe even a lifestyle mock-up that you want to put in your, if you're selling on Etsy or whatever. I'm going to hit crop and there you go. There's my design on a t-shirt, super quick. You can see that that's how you do it on here. It's just you add it. If I needed to add something else, I would replace and it would be the same thing. Grab a design that you already made, put it on the t-shirt, boom, done. And there's a bunch of them. So if you want this one instead, I can just easily just click here and it will keep the same design on there. I'll have to change this t-shirt color, but I can change the t-shirt color to whatever I want too, which is kind of nice. So I can see what it would look like in that color or in that color or that color. I really like the darker ones like that. Pretty cool, right? So there you go. One question I did have is how do I arch the text on the top? Like it would be really cool to arch that text, but you notice that I wasn't able to, like, I don't know if you noticed, but you didn't have like that option. A workaround for that is to look for one that already has an arch text. So if I go back on here, I'm gonna lose this, but that's fine. I already saved it. If I go back to designs, merch print, t-shirt designs, you'll notice that some of them actually have the arch text on here. And some of them actually have two arch texts, like this one right here. So when you come in here and you edit it and you hit this, now this will automatically have the arch text. So I could have come in here and done all my thing, and then I could have said, I paused my game and make sure that it was in the right font. The Junkyard Dog, actually, Junk Dog is pretty a pretty cool one. And I could have come in here and done that and then put my design in here. Let's see. Oh, this one doesn't let you add a background. So there's that. So I think some of them let you do it and some of them don't. And I'm not sure which is which. I wonder if the ones with the arch text don't let you add the background. Let me try one more just for fun here. Designs, merch, t-shirt designs. I don't know if all of them is that way. Let's see this one. I don't know if it says it in here actually. Oh, it actually says the type size or the template. You got 4,000 by 4,800 draggable elements. Let's see if the other one that we picked actually said all those things. So I'm going to go back to hobbies and gaming and see if we can find some of the ones that we did. I actually went all around and I found the different ones. So maybe controller? Gosh, let's see if I can search controller, t-shirt design. All right, let's see if we can find the controller that we did. This is it, okay. So this one, 4,800, draggable elements, and stuff and image. So I don't know. I don't know if it tells you which ones can add designs and which ones can't. Let's see, this one has the arch text, so let's see. I'm gonna hit edit. Ah, so maybe the arch text won't let you add the design on it. You're gonna have to play around with it. I haven't found one that does, but that doesn't mean there isn't one that doesn't. So if you want that arch text, go look for one that does, and hopefully you can add designs to it. Not all of them have that option. I was really lucky on some of them to do that. Let's see if this one does. No, maybe it's some of the newer ones that let you do that, and I was just lucky. Let's go to one more. I'm gonna go designs, t-shirts, and maybe I'll go by newest and see if that's just a new thing that happens. So I'm gonna go, let's see. This one's new and it has the arch text. Let's see if it does it. Come on. Yes. All right. So we're in business. So this one does have the arch text. I can add this here. So it's kind of hit and miss. I don't know if this was the one that actually said that you can add something. So let's see. T-shirt bundles, white, draggable elements bundle. Maybe that's what you're looking for. I don't know if it's there's one that says you can add things to it. So hit and miss. Let me know if you know the answer to this one. But there are some of them that you can add designs to and some of them that you can't. Look for those, maybe save those when you find them and then have fun. But there's a ton of t-shirt design templates here and fonts and so on. So I was really surprised of all the things that Placeit can do with t-shirt designs. Now, is it better than some of the other things out there? No, but you get the mock-ups for free. So if you already have this and are using it for mock-ups, why not use it for designing t-shirts as well? So that was my short tutorial. Hopefully you learned something that I didn't know even, that you can add designs and from Creative Fabrica and backgrounds in here too if you have those. So there you go, that's how you use Placeit to create t-shirt designs for print on demand. Now you can upload those backgrounds, like I said, and if you wanna use the backgrounds that I have on my digital downloads, I'll put that link in the description there. You can see there's 10 of them. I'll be working on even more now that I know you can use these for Placeit and other things. I think it's a good thing to have. You can download backgrounds from Creative Fabrica as well, or wherever that you want to use it, as well as design. So if you want to learn how to use Placeit, I actually have a Placeit playlist that I did. So I'll put that here. I did a lot of Placeit videos about a year ago and stuff, and they're still relevant. You can still use it the same way. Thanks again for watching. And as always, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.